Want a bite? No, thank you. Want to buy roses? Deja vu? Hello, Jonathan. Hello, Shiva. Hello, the Matrixers are here again. Yes, we haven't contacted you for a long time. We had a lot to do, but it will get better in the future. We hope. Yes, as you saw in the intro, today's topic is déjà vu. Correct. Déjà vu, there's a lot to tell. We have déjà vus very often and thought it would be good to make a topic about it. Yes, well, Shiva is, I have to say, the undefeated master of déjà vus. So she always has 10 times as much déjà vus as me. I don't have them very often, but Shiva has 1 to 3 every day. And I find that very significant, because we have already experienced a lot of déjà vus in the course of our lives. We have noticed that there are different déjà vus. Exactly. And of course we asked ourselves the question, what is déjà vus anyway and where does it come from? And the where is actually the who from the future, I would say. So it's actually a self from the future, mostly, that's now addressing the that remembers. So actually we have already experienced this reality and are actually somewhere completely different. And in the future. And in the future we just remember this situation, for example. Yes, but I don't think anyone understood that now. Well, then explain it again in pretty. No, we have to bring examples. Yeah, of course, that was really rough at first and now. Yes, that is very premature. So we have to give examples first. First of all, the classic déjà vu. There are different types of déjà vus. We've got 5 or 6. Yes. And the classic is very classic. Exactly. Well, I had my first déjà vu when I was 20, I think. So I just walked through the forest with such a group. There was such a hike and it was a completely foreign city. I've never been there in my life. And we walked along a dirt road there. And then suddenly there was a clearing and then I looked at the clearing. There were also 3 big boulders, and I looked at them. At that moment my head suddenly clicks and I think, I've definitely been here before. And then I told my friend about it. I've definitely been here. And he was like, how, you've been here before? That's pretty unlikely and all. And he knew me quite well. And yes, I had never been to this place, so I would say it was classic déjà vu. I sensed a place, felt like I'd never been there before. But the déjà vu said to me, you've been here before, right? It was such a classic situation. You sit somewhere or you are somewhere and think, I've had that before. But you'd never had that before. Then there's the déjà vu you just mentioned. That from the future, that the future self is either remembering the present, which means you suddenly know, oh, in the future I've experienced this situation here before. So practically we are in the future right now. I don't think I can explain that very well. Yes, you definitely feel it all of a sudden. The other day I had a déjà vu, when I suddenly knew, this memory that I'm experiencing right now, or the present that I'm experiencing right now, comes from a future or from a future self in 300 years, that this situation already happened 300 years ago once remembered and just remembered, ehm. Experienced and remembered. Yes, I've experienced that too. And then I suddenly had a déjà vu in a very banal situation. And at that moment I thought to myself, oh, wait, now I'm not looking at the déjà vu and not the situation. I'm not questioning the situation either. I'm concentrating now, because such a déjà vu only lasts a few seconds. you don't have much time, too.
Weil so ein Déjà-vu dauert ja immer nur wenige Sekunden, da hat man eben nicht viel Zeit.
The source of déjà vu. Where does it come from? And then I looked into it and was suddenly able to discover a self of mine that, in its presence, about 200,300 years in the future, was remembering the situation I was in. And it was very interesting to feel you had that too. Yes, and another kind of déjà vu that I also get to experience more often is when the future self approaches. So I'll put it the other way around. It's a dream I had once, and the future self is remembering that dream right now in the past, but it's actually happening in the present. And I suspect that this is an alternate reality that where I just have a point of reference. That means I'm probably more or less connected to a self that's experiencing the situation and I'll probably get that. So it's a dream from the past projected into the present by a future self. Very easily. Ah yes, yes that is. That sounds very easy. Yes, absolutely. So the simplified form of this would actually be, you dreamed something and then forgot the dream again. Exactly. And then in everyday life suddenly the situation arises that is exactly like in the dream that one has forgotten and at that moment the dream is remembered again. But sometimes it's also the case that it has nothing at all to do with the current, present or situation, but that you have the feeling, oh, I'm just remembering a dream or a situation from a dream in the past that I have experienced, but which I have not experienced because it is only a dream. Exactly. Well, with déjà vus I noticed that these are always banal situations. Often. Very often banal, completely banal situations. You might see a scene in a movie that's completely boring, maybe, and suddenly you have déjà vu. I've seen that before too. Exactly. Or yesterday. For example, I had three of them. Yes, exactly. And that's kind of. So it doesn't necessarily depend on the situation, it's secondary. The situation was, it's completely banal. So it's really about who remembers the moment you're in right now. But what I have also noticed, more often, there is also a second form, namely that déjà vus are important, in the form that you know you are on the right path. That means the situation isn't even that trivial, but you know, you've experienced it before and you know, oh, this is a point that I experienced on the way to following the higher self. You know what? Was also very often the case. And yes, exactly, there are either the very banal things that you should investigate, where does it come from and why, and those where you know you are investigating certain points and are somehow on the right track. Then there's the déjà vu you just mentioned. From the future. That future self that is either remembering the present, that is, you suddenly know. Oh, in the future I have experienced this situation here before. So practically we are in the future right now. I don't think I can explain that very well. In any case, you suddenly feel it. Recently I had a déjà vu. When I suddenly knew, this memory I am experiencing right now or the present I am experiencing comes from a future. Or from a future self of 300 years from now that remembered this situation 300 years ago and just remembered, experienced and remembered. Yes then there's another form of déjà vu that we wouldn't really classify as déjà vu. But it's something like, for example, I once had a memory that I was in a stalactite cave. I was in a stalactite cave and suddenly a lot of bats came towards me. And I'm quite sure I've never experienced that. so it must have been an alternate self of mine. But I'm not sure either. Maybe I experience it. Maybe it was an alternate self. Maybe it was just a dream. But it feels very real and I know I've experienced it. Or any of mine. Yes, quite possible. Or maybe a reincarnation memory. That is precisely another form, an incarnation memory, that you remember something that is, for example, a current situation and you have a point of reference to a past life, where I am doing something very similar right there. For example, drinking. I'm drinking a coffee right now and that guy over there is also drinking a coffee in my old life. And yes, suddenly a reference point is established. Or at least maybe we are in the same place or the same environment. And then suddenly you remember. And then it seems very old. I have that very often, that it seems very old. The feeling is old and that means it actually comes from another life. But since everything is at the same time, i.e., my old life from the past 20th, 19th century is actually taking place right now. The point of reference is actually now. And that's why we're drinking coffee at the same time. And I remember something old that's actually happening right now too. You can also have deja vus. We've had one together before. You can also experience things together from other incarnations that are taking place now. Everything is possible. Yes. Well, I would say anyway that most of it is reincarnation memory anyway, because it either comes from a self in the future or you are remembering something from a past life. Very few are actually. Well, of course there are also some. You have the feeling that it comes from a future now from this life that, I don't know, is 10 years ahead of you and has already experienced it. And you're going through that right now, like in difficult situations or situations that were important to me, that I had to go through. And knows, oh, the future self has already experienced that in 10 years and is now telling me, yep, let's continue, right, something like that. But most of it is already from other or past future lives, I would say. Yes, one could say that déjà vus are actually primarily reincarnation memories. Because if myself remembers the current situation 200,300 years in the future, that is actually a change in incarnation from its perspective. Exactly. It suddenly occurs to him. Oh yes, since back then in the life in Salzburg in the 21st century, that's right, I lived there. And then he remembers a situation. And so I think when you're having déjà vu, maybe it would be more exciting to retrace the source, rather than going big on the situation that. What you then think about or have the perception of, you have already experienced it. So look immediately, where does that come from? Who remembers me right now? And that, I guess, is déjà vu. Who remembers me right now? Or, I remember someone from the future or from the past. Exactly. Then you are the future now. Yeah, right. And the question is also, why does the future self remember you? Or the past self remembers you, or you remember. Sometimes it's also important to ask why, because sometimes I also have the feeling that this is triggered on purpose. This means that it is not just by chance that the future self remembers a situation, but actually consciously goes into this situation to give me a hint of a path that you have just trodden or something. Oh, well. Another thing I noticed about déjà vus, I've had several of them, is that I've just experienced something and then remember that I experienced it 3 minutes ago. Yes, exactly. So that's that short distance déjà vus. They're like an intro, somehow, short. So I remember just experiencing it a few minutes ago. It's happened to me more than once, but not so much lately. Wanna buy roses? Just like in the intro. Yes, then we already had dream déjà vus, where you dream a situation in a dream, forget the dream and the next day you experience exactly the same situation that you already experienced in the dream and remember the dream at that moment. Or sometimes it's been 10, 20 years since the dream. I have more often. Of course, that can also happen, so it doesn't have to have been yesterday. The dream can also be a few years ago. And I know, I dreamed that and that is important for the current experience now. Why always then I get this dream memory sent? That's right. That's the déjà vus that comes to mind. If any of you can think of another kind of déjà vu, feel free to post it in the comments below. We would be very happy. But we think we've covered 4, 5, 6 déjà vus already. But you never know. Maybe there is another way to experience déjà vu and we would be happy if you write to us about it. Right. That's one direction of timelines. The other, of course, is that you have flashes or predictions. But I think we can make another video about it at some point. Correct. Yes. Thank you for watching. Bye.